We are just about to start period number three. For those of you just joining us, perfect timing here tonight. Colorado's continuing to lead this one by a score of 3-0. The Islanders play it along the boards. And he maintains possession of the puck here. Denies him in close.
What a fantastic save from the high danger scoring area, James. And he's bailing his team out. They have to do a better job of protecting the middle of the ice.
Here's a short pass to Dobson.
And he battled for inside position, and he's able to get a stick on it, just isn't able to get it to the net.
Grabbed along the board by Dobson. Lee's got the puck in his own zone. Fires it! And that one's turned away. Miss it out! You gotta put pucks on net here, come on!
Well, when you're in a grade A scoring chance, right in the inner slot, James, yeah, you gotta find the net, if not the back of it.
The Avs have been the busier team offensively, and as a result, they lead it big time here in this third. The Islanders take possession here inside the offensive zone. Moves it to Nichushkin. Oh, textbook poke check to turn that over. Palmieri's taking it from his own end. Nelson's crossed the line and gained the zone. New York's gained possession along the boards. Oh, he skips into the line of fire and blocks it. Takes a steal out of the ice and loses the puck. And he slides it quickly to Nichushkin. Just a little too much contact and couldn't hang on to the puck. Answered the call there. From the open ice, they gain the line.
Is on and off his stick in a hurry, and it needs to be from that low zone slot area. James just beats the goaltender because he gets off his stick so fast.
The Islanders have to find a way to get a couple more here if they want to try to salvage this one.
Taking calculated risks, James, and jumping into the attack and pressing upwards. Now, you may give up some opportunities the other way, but you got to go for it.
And now it's grabbed by Foot. From the left side, it moves to the middle of the ice. Puck picked up by Rodriguez. And he was right there to make the stop on that play. Gets the puck in deep. Colorado's got a hold of it along the wall. Right in front of the official's eyes, and the hand is in the air. And let's see what the definitive call is on the ice.
Coaches hate stick infractions. They're real frustrating. You're right there. You're in and around the puck. You go fishing, and you wind up in the box.
And the man advantage unit comes out to go to work.
Well, first power play of the game, James. You want to start with possession and look to get shots to the net. It is the tone setter.
Receives the pass.
Chance and one that he will want back. The puck is all around him, though. If he continues to get to the right spots at the right time, you gotta figure he's gonna put one by the tendy.
Pajot's ready for the draw as they continue to be shorthanded here. And off the draw, they win possession. Kulak's got it in the defensive end. Moves it around along the half wall. Glove save made by Kemper. Covers it up and we'll get a stoppage in play. Rodriguez will look to win possession here on the faceoff and try to continue this power play on the right note. Colorado's won the faceoff deep in their own end. And he handles the cross-ice pass. And he'll take a moment to regroup back at center. Sends the pass over. Slides the puck ahead to Drouin. Quick shot! Denies him with the save! Janmark stick handling in his own zone. The Avalanche have gained control of the puck along the wall. Takes a shot! Oh, nice stop with the glove by Forsberg! Breakaway!
one-on-one, you gotta beat the shooter, and that's exactly what he does.
Bailey's ready for the draws. They will continue to try to kill off this penalty.
Kamari's penalty is almost expired.
Drills him! Wicked stop by the goaltender.
Kemper's been strong in the net tonight, and his save percentage is really high, James, and it's because he's faced a high volume of shots and he's been dialed in and able to make the saves. That gives his team confidence, and they've been consistent as well, and they've done the job on the other side of the puck.
McKinnon's aware that possessing the puck is what leads to scoring chances, guys. He's got that unstoppable force zone ability, which is his strength and balance on his feet that helps him shrug off defenders, especially when he's carrying it into the zone.
Looks to make a play over to Bailey. With possession along the wall. Now making this a one-goal game.
Bench is up and stick taps all the way around, getting within one goal in the third period. You know how important this faceoff is to get possession and start attacking in the O zone.
Quick feed to Cogliano. Crosses the puck loose. Takes the pass. The Avs get a hold of the puck in their own end. Colorado's got it in their own zone. Here they come up along the wing. Dumps it in. The Islanders have it now. And some good footwork to kick it away. Taken along the wall by Pajot. The Islanders are on the attack. Great puck check on the reach.
I've really enjoyed this game tonight, James. It's been tight, it's been fast-paced, defensively structured, and you never know which way it's going to end.
Great stretch, passes and connects. And that's poked away by Girard. Moves it quickly over to Bertrand. Save! Oh my goodness!
Well, go technique out the window. This time it's all about the competitive will to get to that puck.
Quick pass to Cogliano. Dumped in and they'll go off. The Islanders have it against the wall. Slides the puck across to Wahlstrom. Battle along the boards. Takes it from the right side. Here's a shot! Stopped by the goaltender. The Avalanche have taken possession along the wall. Through the neutral zone now, picking up steam. Takes a shot. Turned aside with a glove by Forsberg. Ottawa's on the schedule next, and tickets still available for this one, so get them before they're gone. And look at this, Pounder. Look who's right back out there for the faceoff.
Well, I'll tell you what, it wouldn't have been me back in the day because I didn't score goals. I was always protecting the lead. But you got to get your role players off of the ice, and you got to get your scores on the ice. And that's exactly what's happening here.
Wahlstrom's got it into offensive territory. Cuts to the front. How did he stop that one?
What an incredible save in a high-danger scoring area. I mean, right in the spot, he's perfect position to make that glove save.
Colorado's been on a roll all night long, and they continue to lead in the third. Nice job tying up his opponent. The Avs have played it through the neutral zone. Good reach for the stick to knock the puck away. Nice zone entry from the middle. Drives to the sweet spot. Too many bodies in the way. The Avs gain the zone. Here's a chance! Turned aside with a glove by Forsberg. A lot on the line here in this offensive zone faceoff. The Islanders come up with a defensive zone draw. From the defensive zone, they move the puck around. The Avalanche have taken possession of their own end. We got a whistle. Penalty coming up.
Well, you can see the pent-up frustration. That's his second penalty of the period. Now he's put his team in a compromised position. Not to mention he's affected their rhythm.
Yeah. opportunity coming up here as they set up at the faceoff.
Well, they haven't scored on the power play yet, Dan. It is a tough thing to do, and this is an earned opportunity. They've practiced. They know what they're doing. It'll come.
On the left side, he moves it up ahead. The Islanders looking against the half wall. Beautiful read in the defensive end by McCall. Moved up ahead here in the neutral zone. Here's a great use of the stick right there to poke it away. Keeps a hold of it on the play. The Islanders get a hold of the puck under man. They try to maintain possession inside the defensive zone. Colorado's got the puck. Gaining momentum along the wing. Big save by the goaltender watching that one.
Goaltender spent so much time doing tracking exercises, and it's utilized right here as he knows where this puck is coming from, and he makes the save.
Here's a short pass to McKinnon. Shot. Oh, slick work with the glove by Forsberg. They'll get set to drop the puck as this power play continues. New York's got it in the defensive zone. Slides the puck over. Moves it to Susie. Through center along the wing. Here's a shot.
Oh, how did I miss from there?
Well, this is a tough miss, James. I think he might have rushed it or even panicked a little bit. Typically, he's going to put the shot on target, but instead, he misses.
Turn that one aside. Here inside the offensive end. And they win the draw in the offensive zone, and they go to work. Loose puck, and they're off to the races. The Avs have it behind the cage. And now they look to make something happen from the neutral zone. Excellent stick work on the play. Can't hang on to the biscuit after that. Has made his way to the bench. The extra attackers out. They need a goal here big time. Scores into the empty net, and that should probably wrap this one up.
Yeah, well, it'll seal the deal, James. The insurance marker, and a lot of fun as well. Goal scoring is fun. Doesn't matter how it goes in, even if it is an empty net. On the dying moments of the game, they get the empty netter, James, and that's just a result of having urgency, making sure they protect the middle of the ice, and hey, they get it down the ice and get the empty netter to boot.
The Avs have been the busier team in the shot department, and they lead it late in this third period. McKinnon's won the draw at center. Looking to make something happen along the boards. Stopped by the goaltender. The Avs will play for the corner. 4 seconds. There's the final horn, and this one's in the books. The Avs filled the net often in the first, but then just really kind of played back and defended the rest of the way.
Yeah, it's a bit of a gamble when you sit back on your heels a little bit too much. Can certainly go the other way, but it didn't for them tonight. They were able to close it up and just find a way to win.